Howdy folks, and welcome to Let's Play Wizards and Warriors 3, Kuros Visions of Power, released in 1991 by Acclaim. You guys have, I'm sure, seen my Let's Beat of this, and whereas that showcased the end of the game, this is going to showcase everything from the beginning through to the end. As you can see here, once it is loaded, it is a fairly standard side-scroller by immediate looks. Move with the D-pad, although in my case a thumbstick. A jumps, and B puts you into attack mode. One unique thing about this game is that once you are in attack mode, you actually have to tap the D-pad in the direction of that you wish to attack, which would actually make the combat system in this game quite cool if the down attack wasn't the best one in the whole game. So, now, you immediately notice that we are in a town! We are, for the most part, safe here, in so long as we are Kuros, which we are right now. We're not in any of the guild suits. Our immediate goal is to earn enough money to purchase two keys, which will cost us 180 coins. This is an inn. We can't do anything here yet, but later on we will be able to buy food and keys there. Alright, that is money. And that is a townless person I just shoved to his death. that's food. It will heal you if you are injured, which we are not. I really shouldn't just be picking it up willy-nilly, because later on this game will get pretty rough, and we'll want to conserve all that. Now, I'm playing this on an emulator, and I will be employing save states, because this is one of those old-school NES games where the developers thought it'd be cute to not let you continue after you've run out of your lives. We have 3 lives. You can get more in the game, I believe, by getting a, like, 20,000 score. I'm not sure the exact number. But once you run out, you have to start the whole game over. Now, I can get to the end boss with 3 lives. It's really not that hard. It's beating the end boss with 3 lives. So, we are probably going to only be employing save states in certain areas. Notably, before we do any of the guild challenges, because they are kind of unfairly difficult. But also, we'll probably be employing them before boss fights and stuff like that. But I'm not going to be like, oh look, I collect money, save state. Okay, we're at 120, only need 60 more. Have we gone in here yet? No. Right, earning money like adventures, by burgling people's homes. Hells yeah. Alright. Nothing more in here. Alright, we're good. Gotta do is find that dank tower. It's right here? Yes. Okay. What can I do for you? Give me keys! Alright. Now, later in the game, actually near the end of the game, it's one of the last guild memberships you get the third tier thief, which actually allows you to... I could have just grabbed that from the beginning, but it allows you to open any door without the need of keys. However, I'm going to probably buy like 30 keys just to be sure. And this is the Thieves Guild.
Welcome, sir, to the first level of the Thieves Guild. Do you wish to join?
Why, of course.
You must bring the long-lost bronze statue back to this guild. Go now.
Alright, and that is a running thing throughout this game. To get each level in a guild, you have to bring back their statue. The Thieves Guild statue happens to be right over here. Huzzah! And each guild has 3 of them. So, it's as a rule, pretty straightforward. Later on, we'll actually have to beat boss monsters to get the further in statues. But the first statue in each guild, you just have to find it. So that's not too bad. Alright, and we are going to save. As you can see in the bottom left corner, it says save state. And we are going to go in.
Welcome, sir, the first level, yada yada yada.
Yes!
Ah, you have returned the statue, many thanks. Before you can join, you must pass my test.
Alright, and we are going to save again right here, because this thing sucks. Each guild has tests you have to pass, and there's a boss at the end that you have to fight to get the suit. The Thieves Guild tests are probably some of the nastiest in the games, because there are a lot of death traps in them. The arrows won't insta-kill you, but they'll send you flying. Spikes on the ground, obviously. You hit those and you're done. And, I'm actually surprised I haven't died yet. And the Thieves Guild gimmick is these doors. They change color and teleport you to likely colored doors. Like, see? There we go. And there we go. Okay, that orange door is obviously a death trap. Alright, and now we are going to fight the boss. And the first tier bosses are actually fairly easy. You can just, if you're careful... I'm actually going to switch back to D-pad. Well, screw you, bud. But you can sneak up, like, right in front of them like this, and beat the holy crap out of them. The mage guilds are actually the easiest ones. Because, if you get in just the right place, they actually can't hurt you at all. And this guy is just kicking my butt, dang. Dang it. Alright, and as you can see, we got our butt whooped. And when you fail, you lose 3 health, which we save stated before, so we're just going to load right back up. Because otherwise, I'm going to just repeatedly get ridiculously owned by these guys, and yeah. I don't want to be having lives lost because of me being stupid in here. And the platforming in this is actually harder than it looks. Kuros, when he gets moving, he gets momentum behind him, and he's actually quite hard to stop. So you'll notice it particularly in the Mage Guild tests. I'll be falling to my death a lot in those. Because they're all about precision jumping, and I hate precision jumping. Alright, let's try this again. Nope. Dang it. There we go. And, as I said, this guy's pretty easy, but later in, they get to the point where they'll actually, like, charge across the room at you, and that's when it gets really bad. The Thief and Warrior guilds do that. The Mage's Guild never does, which, actually, I could, like, if I could get into the Mage Guild, I could beat the third tier Mage Guild with just this basic thing right here, because it's just so easy. Which actually reminds me, you do have to beat it with this basic suit of armor. Later in the Warriors Guild, you get better suits of armor. And to take the test, you always have to go back in as standard Kuros, which is what I am right now. And we have unlocked the Thief suit, along with 1,000 points. And the people in town like the Thief, who has the fastest run speed in the game. Mage has the highest jump speed, or rather the highest jump. And the Warrior Kuros, he's pretty evenly rounded. I will be spending probably 90% of the time as him. Alright, and we are going to blow all of our money on keys. Alright. And this game does have a rudimentary faction system to it. Like, if I come in town as the wizard, townsfolk will attack me and stuff. And I'm going to save right here. And if we enter here as anybody but the Thief, he wakes up and he will kick our butt. But we will come back later in the game and thoroughly murder him. But that won't be for a while yet. Alright, and in that door right there is the first wizard statue. Yay. Right. Okay, switch back to Kuros. Save and go on in. Welcome, sir, to the first level of the Wizards Guild. Do you wish to join? Yes! Ah, you have returned the statue. Many thanks. Before you can join, you must pass my test. Save. I hate these so much. And I apologize if I'm being quiet, but when I run these things, I tend to sit here with my tongue wagging out of my head, trying to keep from falling to my death. Ooh, that was lucky. Dang it! Alright, as you can see, the boss filter filled in the bottom, which means boss time. Alright, and I think it's right about here. Yeah, he can't hit us, we can hit him, and he'll shoot snakes. Shoot your snakes. Shoot your snakes. Ah, he's not gonna shoot snakes. But he shoots snakes and they land and they run across. But yeah, that's that. Easy. It's the levels that suck on him.
Well done, you're now the first level member of the Mages Guild. Take your cloak and carry your new staff with pride.
Which, as a first level mage, we now have the benefit of Fiery Death! Yeah. Which, if you get good with it, is actually probably one of the more effective weapons in the game. Until you get, I want to say, second tier warrior, where you get a really cool axe. Alright, we can't go through here yet. And as you can see, he woke up and was going to maim us quite thoroughly. But we are coming through again, sneaking past him.
Fear my two-frame sneak animation.
Alright, now that we're in town, I can show you guys the factions. And the first townsperson that we bump into is going to try to kill us. Hopefully it'll be one of the little midgets. Yeah. Yeah, they're pretty harmless. They just kind of, like, swing in the air. And I send them flying with my fiery death.
The worst ones to bump into are actually the dogs, I want to say.
There's these tall guys that wander around, but they're not too bad. They're a bit more in your face than those midgets are. But the dogs are the worst because they're, like, heat-seeking death, as you can see. And most enemies in this game have a lot of hit points. Nothing really dies easily, so it's... Ah, you suck. But it's actually often better to avoid combat. Because... Actually, that's what I'm going to do right now. Because you really don't have the hit points to just be jacking around like I was there. Alright. And here's what the wizard is useful for. Destroying bees. Amazing. And he was... Ah, there we go. He's the one that lets us jump up here. Oh, we're going back to Rogue for the time being. Fear the thiefy dude with the awesome beard. Alright, actually I might be able to show you guys. All the way over here. Is it? Yeah, we can't get past that yet. It's the force field. You need, I want to say, the second level of wizard. Let you get past that, and then through there is the second level of warrior. But we don't have to worry about that yet. We are going this way. And we are switching, actually, before we go in there. We are switching back to Kuros. Because we are going up into the castle, where everybody hates us. As Kuros will be attacked, actually as anybody will be attacked up there because we don't have warrior yet, but once we get the warrior, we'll be able to come up here without guards hucking spears and other sharp projectiles at us. Alright, I think this is the guild. Oh no, this is the inn, which I'll show you guys something here real quick. You go into the inn as the thief.
But I'm afraid I only serve knights at this inn. Punt!
So as you can see, now I should be able to go in as Kuros. And, yeah. Guess Kuros passes for a knight. And you can buy gossip too, which is...
I believe that the king has been tied up and locked away behind the throne room.
Why aren't you, you know, alerting the guard to this friend? I also like the music in here. Alright, but the Warriors Guild is right near here, but we're going to get the statue first, because I should be able to get it in before I hit the 15-minute mark. Alright, here we go.
You have found the Bronze Knight statue. Because we're badass.
Alright. And... Let's see here. I want to say the Fighter Guild is right... over here.
Haha! Favorite music in the game. Welcome to the first level of the Knights Guild. You should join.
No! I don't like you. You're a jerk. Alright, and I'm going to pause it, save it, and I will see you folks next time.